And today, I would like to discuss an essay on Towards a Feminist Poetics by Elaine Schwalter. This is a very important essay created by Elaine Schwalter. And Elaine Schwalter is an American critic. She is a social and political writer and a feminist. In this essay, Towards a Feminist Poetics, she has made feminist criticism into two groups. And she says that feminist criticism can be divided into two distinct varieties. And the first variety is woman as a reader. And for this phase, for this category, she has named it as a feminist critic. When woman was a reader, she has been read the male-produced literature and she imbibed or internalized the canons and values of the male writers, so that her subject was included the images and stereotypes of women in literature, the omissions and misconceptions about women in criticism, and the fissures in male-constructed literary history. Means, she only thought about images and stereotypes created by the man, like Sita and Savitri, Damayanti, whom we call as Pativratas. And these were the models or the images created by the man. And the people, means the writers of this feminist criticism, woman as a reader, they followed these norms. Means, they imitated the male writers. But they also understood how these images and stereotypes have been created by the man. Because they wanted, the male society wanted the woman always to be subservient. And also, this category, the feminist critique, they try to understand the omissions and misconceptions about women in criticism. Means the male-dominated society really did not understand the woman properly. Even Aristotle, a great philosopher, he thought that women have less teeth than the man. But scientifically, it is an absurd phenomenon. But everybody believed Aristotle, and they thought that woman's knowledge is insignificant and she is inferior to man and she is a weaker sex. These are all misconceptions nursed by the male-dominated society. And also, this feminist critic, they try to understand fissures in male-constructed literary history. Means, in the male-constructed history, only man has a place, whereas woman has no place at all. That's why it is his story. The feminists claim that history is his story. It is not her story. No woman queens or princesses have place in the history. Only it is a man-made history. That's why only man has his own place there. And this feminist critics, they also concerned with the exploitation and manipulation of the female audience, especially in popular culture and film. In the film, you might have seen that woman is used as a heroine. Her beauty is exposed, her dance talents have been exposed, and she has been reduced as an item girl in most of the films. And rapes that happen on the women, they have been normalized or naturalized in the film. And all such kinds of things have been exposed by the feminist critic. So this is the first variety, woman as a reader or feminist critic. Now let us come to the second variety. In the second variety, the feminist criticism, here our concern, Elaine Schwalter's concern, is mainly on woman as a writer. And she is the producer of textual meaning with the history, themes, genres, and structures of literature by women. Means she has selected her own theme, her own genre, her own structure of literature. Because male-dominated societies, the themes were different. There, the woman was just used as a pativrata, or she has used as a subservient to the man. She was just like a slave, and she was a doll in the hand of a man. But the modern feminists or woman as a writer, they try to frame woman in a new personality with her own feelings and experiences. In order to shoot their theme, they started to identify or they started to write in a new genres and structures of literature. And the subject they mainly focused on were the psychodynamics of female creativity, linguistics, and the problem of female language. And even the language is made by the man. So that they rejected this man-made language. In order to shoot women's experiences and feelings, they wanted to reconstruct the language. So, gynocritics have tried hard in order to reconstruct even the history, because history is also man-made. Gynocritics wanted to write their own history with a female perspective. They wanted to present their own experiences, feelings, and emotions in the literature. So far, men have their own literature, but women have no history of her own. Elaine Shorter, in her book, A Literature of Their Own, formulated 3 pages of feminist criticism. And she named the first phase as a feminine phase, and the second phase as a feminist phase, and the third one is a female phase. In the first phase, we have seen writers like Jane Austen, Bronte sisters, and George Eliot. Here, women wrote in order to equal the intellectual achievements of the man. And for that, these writers, as they have internalized male-oriented literature or male norms and canons, they wrote in imitation of the man. As women's writing was considered silly, some writers, they kept their name as man. For example, George Eliot. George Eliot's original name is Mary Evans. As she thought nobody will read my reading, she changed her name as George Eliot. So, keeping such kind of a male pseudonym was natural in the first phase. And this phase runs from 1840 to 1880. And the second phase, which is called a feminist phase, that feminist phase runs from 1880 to 1920. And at this time already, women have won the voting rights. And the women writers of this period, they rejected all values and canons of male-dominated society. And they wrote against the patriarchy, and they rejected all kinds of modeling postures of femininity. The second phase is a protest phase, whereas the third phase, which we call as female phase, it is not like the first feminine phase as they imitated the male writers. And it is also not like the second phase, feminist phase. As the feminist writers, they protested against the male-dominated society. And these writers of a female phase, they try to write are about their own feelings and emotions, keeping female at the center. And they wanted literature as autonomous art. And representative writers of the age are Dorothy Richardson and Virginia Woolf. So they try to reconstruct the history, the language, everything from the female perspective. And feminist criticism cannot go around forever in men's ill-fitting hand-me-down. So John Stuart Mill says that emancipate itself from the influence of accepted models and guide itself by its own impulses. So feminist criticism should guide its own impulses. The woman writers should write about their own natural instinctive characters. That's what they were highlighted. So these are three important pages of feminist criticism. Feminine, feminist, and female pages. And here, the main challenge for feminist and female critics was the language. They wanted to reconstruct language in order to meet their own mental character, in order to shoot their experiences and other aspects. So the task of feminist critics is to find a new language, a new way of reading, not only the language, but they have to read between the lines in order to identify the hidden meanings of the female writers. And this reading should integrate our intelligence and our experience, our reason and our suffering and our skepticism and our vision. So all these things should be intermingled in the language. That is the feeling of the gynocritics. That's why Elaine Schwalter says that this is not just confined to the women. So she invites the men also, the men critics, men philosophers, men poets should participate in a continuation of this criticism. And at the end, she says that feminist criticism is not just visiting. There are a number of other literary criticisms, literary theories, which will come to the front line at some time, and after that they will disappear. But feminism is not like that. It will stay here forever until the last woman lives on this earth. So, Elaine Schwalter says that we shall make this as a permanent home. Thus, Elaine Schwalter has proposed independent literary theory for women. And also, she has recalled the history of female writers from the feminist perspective. Thank you.